Hi, today I would like to show you the game that I played yesterday in the Lone Wolf competition. I played against a player rated 2200, and I lost this game, so it was not the best experience for me. And it's of course crucial if you want to improve in chess that you try to learn from your mistakes, try to learn from analyzing your games, which is something that I find difficult to do for myself. As a trainer, as a coach, I manage to do this for students who are weaker players than I am. But doing this for yourself is not so easy. Yet I'm going to make an attempt to have a look at the game and see where I went wrong and what happened. So my opponent played d4, which I expected, and I reacted with d5, which is not my normal move to play. Normally I play things like knight f6 or sometimes f5, and I play these moves to create wild positions, complicated positions. And this time I selected an opening I never played, with another idea in mind. I was trying to get some kind of position where I would just play normal moves and reach a position where I could try to outplay him by playing good positional chess. That was my idea. So I prepared a little, so I knew that he played e6, c4. I reacted with e6, which I never played before. Knight c3, and now I knew that if I play something like bishop e7 or knight f6, he would go for the exchange variation, for example, like this. I prepared instead to play a6, which is a move that he hadn't had in practice at Lee Chess yet. So I was quite certain that I would surprise him with this move. The Janowski defense, it's called. It has a solid reputation. It's not well known. It's a solid reputation, and black can use it to play it for a win. So for this reason, it seemed quite suitable. And I was quite certain that he would react in the same style as he would do in a queen's gambit, and he did. So he went for some kind of exchange variation, knight f3, and after knight f6, he played bishop g5, which I expected. So now the main move for black is bishop e6, which is a typical move for black in the exchange or in the queen's gambit in general. The idea is that you want to cover d5 without committing to c6, because okay, c6 and a6 might seem as a strange combination at this point at least. Now I saw that there are some wilder lines like queen b3, but I expected him to stay loyal to his normal development with e3, and I continue with some natural moves. And as you can see, black already has quite has some pros when you compare it to the Queen's Gambit, to the normal Queen's Gambit. So he has an active bishop at f6, at d6, and most notably, his bishop at e6 is not as bad as in the normal Queen's Gambit where it's closed in. So white played rook c1, I played c6 at this point. Black also has a nice control over e5, by the way. Queen c2, h6, bishop h4, bishop g3 first, queen c7. All of this is quite normal, and black should not have any difficulties here. At this point, one of the things that I was considering was to play c5 at a certain point. Well, first of all, I'm not used at all to playing with the isolated pawn. So I'm always a little bit reluctant to do this. There is a downside of it because the black square bishop is gone. So with a bishop at d6, it would have been much better to play c5. But I consider my position well developed, well structured, and he's not really in a position to, for example, to occupy d4 with his knights. I always have counterplay. I have e4. I have the open line with my rook. So it was something that I contemplated, but I didn't pursue in the end. So I played rook c8 as possibly as a decision to continue with this. And for example, if he plays h3 or something, well, I could of course continue developing my rook, or I could play c5. And this is a well. This is a decent move. It has been played by strong players, and well, it's about equal. And and these games all ended in a draw. But my opponent, he played knight a4, so possibly he wanted to do something against c5. I reacted quite well, I think. I played knight e4, so he goes to the side of the board. I tried to occupy the center with the idea that if he goes for a capture, this might look a little bit inferior for black because he captures the a pawn, because he gives up a central pawn in return. But I thought it was quite okay because, okay, you have the bishop, which is a nice piece now. You have some possibilities for majority on the queen side. And a move like e4 I was not so afraid of. I can undermine the center, for example, at this moment. This would have pleased me. If I don't know for sure that I would have... I know for sure that I would have done it. But my opponent, he played knight c5. Which I was a move that I liked, because okay, I take like this, and now queen e7. I was satisfied with this. He gets d4 with for his knight, but I have this d5, so I have a little bit more space in the center. My knight at d7 is also a promising piece. It can go to e5 later on to c4 perhaps, and this bishop is still not bad. Though, of course, it's a bit closed in by these pawns. But all in all, I was satisfied, and I believe I was. It was correct to be satisfied. Black is equal. He played b4, and now I played bishop e4. And while this is not a bad move, of course, perhaps I'm striving too much for complications. So, as I said, I like to play with things like the Dutch or like the King's Indian, some slightly weird, complicated positions. And I try to complicate the game and try to profit from this. While in this position, things are much more balanced, and you have to try to outplay your opponent, for example, by striving to end up with the best piece and to get this piece on a strong square, for example, to be concrete, to exchange these bishops and to end up with the better knight at e5 or at c4. And then, for example, to play a5 at a certain moment to undermine these pawns. This would be a decent strategy in this game. And you can prepare this with some nice calm moves. For example, rook e8, just putting it on an open file, a3, for example. And then something like rook a8 to open the file, to open the queen side, and stuff like this. But all in all, it remains very balanced, of course. And if you play this, objectively speaking, you cannot really hope for more than a draw with black. And of course, I tried to win this game. So I played bishop d4, and it cost me a move, actually, because the way that white continues, I just have no use of this move. So I should have made a more useful move like rook e8 or queen f6 or something. So he goes to d4, knight e5. So I was hoping for bishop f5, which he did. I was still not dissatisfied, and I'm still very fine, I believe, about equal. But the best move at this point appears to be queen f6 again to have the queen somewhat active. I decided to go to d7. And okay, this is slightly more passive, of course. I'm defending this pawn. It's also on this open file, so white can continue with rook d1 and with the idea to play e4 next. So this is already slightly imprecise, and I believe white begins by getting a slight edge. But okay, he played knight d6. I was not so afraid of this knight because I saw that I can play, for example, knight g4, knight f6, knight e8. It didn't bother me that much. This knight is okay. It's, for the moment, it's standing very strongly, but I can chase it right quite easily. Now I played rook a8 to potentially open the file and seize the a file. Queen c3, possibly e4 is better, but queen c3 was played. Knight g4, this appears to be a lesser move. But as you can see, if we look at the strongest continuation for white, which would have been f3, knight f6, e4, you can see that white is gaining a grip in the center. And If I guess this is the thing that I missed in this game, at this point of the game at least. Namely, I neglected the center in a certain way. And by neglecting this, I allow my opponent to claim a grip, which he didn't do. So he played a more natural h3. The more, well, this is of course a move like f3 is more concrete because you're preparing some very specific line. h3 is a very general move. You just make a hole for the king. You chase the knight and you keep the structure intact. So it's a much more human move at least, but it allows black to, it doesn't create e4, so it gives black a little bit more time and space. Rook d1, yeah, and now for one reason or another, I don't know what exactly, but I think knight d8 is an equalizer. But okay, this is of course a very dry position, and I was aiming to outplay him. So I played queen e7 with some ideas, well, I don't know which ideas exactly, but okay, I had some ideas in mind. Rook d4, now knight e8, and this is of course less strong now, because I allow him, well, it's all equal in the end, it's all equal, I must not say it's less strong, it's all equal, because okay, he cannot really assault my king, king is safe, so it's all okay. And now I play king h8, which is, okay, I don't know why I did this move. It's neglecting the play in the center. Knight c7 appears to be the best move, improving the knight to e6. But okay, this move is not useful. Suppose if you look at the computer, you have, for example, rook f4. And if now knight c7, knight d6, queen e7. Rook g4 with the idea knight f5. And if now knight e6, you have e4, and why this making progress? He's making progress. He's opening files. He's opening lines. This queen can get to the king. So okay, it's not easy to see. But you can see that it evolves around the center and that. Black neglected a little bit. White also does so, it's not so well played. But this is also an accuracy, also because it also does the same. It doesn't look at the center. I get my knight a little bit better, and now I found the time there to open this file, which is a decent move. So he takes, and this is fine for me apparently, but I should have played h5 at this point, which with the idea, okay, the rook has no squares on the fourth rank, so we must go to g3, and it's sidelined now, which you can obviously see like this. Okay, the rook can go to f3, but it's a little bit, well, black is okay here at this point, because this rook at f3 is out of play. And this knight is also tied to the defense, so it's something I should have done probably. But I took at once, and as a result, it took all into play. But I saw, okay, my knight is now getting active, so I was a little bit satisfied. I have this idea at a3, which he overlooked, I guess. But in the end, if you look at it with the computer, you can still see that. That white should be a little bit better, because okay, I guess this pawn might become a strong one. I don't know. It seems in the end for me it seemed quite equal. The computer said it's better for white, it all when I look at it like this now, it all seems that we kind of neglected the center a little bit, and that because of this the balance could have been broken. Now he gave up the exchange, or he blundered the exchange, and this was actually I'm now at the best position I got in this game. I'm an exchange up for a pawn, I believe, and his knight is kind of stranded. My rooks can find open files, I should have won this position with black, but I I decided at this point I must also mention, by the way, that we had little time left, about a minute, 2 minutes. So the mistakes really begin now, and it's not so strange given the time limit. But for one way or another, I was focusing on this a pawn, which was quite useless because he can push it to a5 when it's defended, stably defended by the knight. He can defend the knight as well by rook b6 and queen b3, for example. So this is, I should have noticed that it is a little bit useless. I should have played d4, which is not such a strange move, because, okay, you're threatening a very dangerous thing, so he must exchange. And now your queen really gets into the game. He must play a5, king g8 to defend f7, and you're ready to really activate this rook one way or another. And for example, this rook can go to the king side, can attack g2, and normally black should be able to win this quite easily. I missed it, simply said. So first I did this game, this move a5, a bit less, and now this. It should still be better for black, but here I lose my advantage. The computer says queen e7, which is a move I didn't contemplate, so possibly it's possible, but it's difficult. Again, I have a minute left, so I played it safe. I thought I played it safe. I had this idea, by the way, that he would play. Probably I misjudged it somewhere. I had this idea that I was thinking about this one, but I saw that this is obviously a mate at b8. So I was contemplating about taking on e5. That was my idea. So I played g6, g3, and now I first played my king g2, and at this point I played rook a7. I immediately regretted this move, and I thought afterwards that I should have taken at a5 at once. And I believe this was winning, but I had something in mind like this. Now c5 is hanging, so you must play queen b4. And at this point, I thought, okay, rook a2 is close to winning. Because, for example, if he plays queen a1, I have rook c2. And this I believe I would win. It's still pretty equal, but given my experience that players tend to play very bad in the endgame, and that I had 200 points more than him, I was very confident for this. At this point, white can play queen f4, and this is a serious spoiler, because if you take this pawn is hanging, and okay, this should be not like this, of course, rook b2. And this is a little bit more struggling for black, but I think I must be able to hold it, because these pawns will get exchanged in the end, and it will be a draw. Maybe I would have done something like queen e6. Then you have this this idea, and queen e4 holds the balance, but not much more than this. So this is again, this is a complete draw, I believe. But okay. Immediately when I played this move, I saw, okay, I have a problem. He prevents me from taking now. And now I played queen e7. This is the blunder of the game for me. And again, it's kind of, if I look at it now, I can kind of explain it by neglecting the center. So I leave control over this diagonal in the hands of my opponent, and this is killing me. So I should have recognized that this diagonal is a very important one, and I should have just settled for a draw with a move like this. And it's still okay, it should be a draw. Why this knight is really compensating my hook, so it should be a draw. Queen e7 now, not king g7 because of this fork, of course. Queen e7 to keep the queen out of b7, and black is not able to activate, or at least it would be very risky to activate. Okay, of course I didn't like it, and I didn't like this opening to struggle that much that I would settle for a draw. I wanted to outplay my opponent, didn't succeed in this. I of course I tried to push it, which I don't think is a bad thing, but I just make this problem that this wrong estimation that I could leave this diagonal. I didn't saw it at all that this diagonal was such a problem for me. Again, I have 1 minute left, so it's I can't find some excuse in this. My opponent, he captured the diagonal. Apparently, it was stronger to take it at b2 to keep b7 cover, but okay. F6 is the best move, but I was still not completely... Well, f6 is perhaps a decent move, because the best move, computer says, is knight d6 with a fork looming. I can play like this, and it's still relatively equal, but okay. I didn't thought it was that bad. Knight d6 now. And okay, I thought this one was coming. And this is a bad move again. I should have taken now. And if the hook comes, there's a mate at h8, so f6 now. And okay, it's... I was not able to judge all of this. It's an annoying endgame for black, because white will win this pawn at c6, and he will have a more active hook as well. But I was kind of surviving. This is not a good move, because I can take, and if he plays rook b8, well, I took in any case. So, and now I let's have a look. Yeah, I played queen g7, and this is a mistake, I guess. Well, no, it's not a mistake. Yeah, I could have gone to rook a2, but okay, queen g7, queen b6. Rook a2, this is all fine still. Queen b8, my opponent, I must say my opponent played very well, by the way. He also was in time trouble, but he kept on playing very strongly in this phase. Now, this is the crucial point. I had 2 minutes left, and after my next move, I had 10 seconds left. So, I got 30 seconds on plus of this, but when I played my g5, I had 10 of 20 seconds left. I obviously saw that I had serious problems, and I didn't have the time to see through them well enough. So I should have played rook b2, and in hindsight, it's a very logical move, because it neutralizes this rook and it neutralizes any attacking potential, because these three pieces, they are combining against black's king. So I must neutralize this. I must eliminate a defender, an attacker. And I can do this by rook b2. If he moves this rook, for example, he will be lost. If he exchanges like this, it's not easy for him. Well, he will play knight e8. I think he will play knight e8. And rook a2, for example, and then he will have a perpetual like this, which I believe he would have found. Quite easily. You would have found it quite easily, I think. I just overlooked rook b2. So I don't recall which moves I was contemplating. I remember I was thinking about h5, but then this one is a problematic move. And if my queen moves, yes, knight f6, and this is gone. I couldn't completely calculate it, but I saw something like, well, this is already winning for black, apparently. At this point, he has to play this move. So, and this is the only move to win. Well, no, he has f4. No, he doesn't have f4. So this is the only move to win. With the point being like this. This I saw. Okay. And this, yeah, I overlooked. I've seen this line. I've seen, okay, if he has this, I have rook e7 perhaps. But okay, this is already mate at default, so this is not it. But I overlooked also that he has, yeah, okay, it's lost. So Well, let's go to the finish. I played this terrible move, d5. I immediately saw f5 as a problem. And this is this lost in the end. Because I have this mating line that I couldn't do anything with. I thought this was a draw, actually. I thought I had a perpetual, but it was very naive of me, because yes, king e1, I cannot give a check anymore, and it's a mated one. So very well played by my opponent. At points it was difficult for him. He played very well, he defended very well, and in the end he finished off very nicely. And the statistic was clearly in his favor, so he beat me very well. I have to keep on holding the focus on the center. That's my lesson, I think. Thank you for watching. See you.